I'm Don Nelson. Here are your top headlines. The city of Boise is installing facial recognition technology at City Hall, all part of an effort to keep banned people from entering government buildings. Officials say the technology will cost more than $50,000 to install at Boise City Hall and City Hall West. The technology will help identify people who enter the buildings in violation of legal no-contact orders. Some cities in the U.S. have banned the facial recognition technology because of concerns it could be misused or violate civil rights. But officials say the data collected by Boise system will not be stored or connected to any police database or criminal records. Officials say facial recognition will likely be in use by the end of this year. No one is currently banned from City Hall. When most of us think of frogs, we probably remember catching them or maybe hesitating to do so as a child. But frogs are a vital part of the ecosystems in our state, and they can indicate the health of those ecosystems. That's why the Nature Center was proud to host the unveiling of the U.S. Postal Service's latest forever stamps that pay tribute to four frog species. Two of those are native to Idaho and one is not doing well. Leopard frogs are declining for two main reasons: a global fungus and the use of pesticides in agriculture. The idea behind the stamps is to help draw attention to the vital species and to educate Idahoans about the many types of frogs found in the Gem State. The new frog stamps are forever stamps, meaning you can use them even if postal rates go up. They are available online, by phone, and of course at the post offices throughout the country.
Meteorologist Scott Norvell with the On Your Side forecast.
Happy Wednesday, everybody. It's midweek and it's getting hot. Temperatures have been heating up, but as I mentioned yesterday, the cloud cover that you see here was increasing. So we've had kind of a gray overcast day. Despite the cloud cover, we're still getting those hotter temperatures, or hotter air masses moving in. And tomorrow we'll have the hotter weather, even hotter than today, with sunshine. We'll make you feel that much more significantly hotter. So we're near 90. We'll go above 90 today. We should be above 90 for a high temperature, giving us above normal temperatures. In the mountains, 77 to 82. It's on the warm side, and it is nice. Now, we've got some cloud cover, but there's some sunshine coming through. It's looking nice everywhere. This is that cloud cover, that high cloud cover that's been streaming through the region. You see, continuing to move on through. That stream of moisture coming in from the south and west will continue. And to the north and west is a storm system that's keeping it cool, but it's pumping the heat up into our direction. So that's what's coming in with the cloud cover. That the layer of clouds will thin out tonight. So tomorrow, sunshine, 96. So we'll bump it up another 3 or 4 degrees, getting very hot tomorrow. Call it scorching heat coming in Friday and Saturday at 98. So getting close to 100. Some places in the valley will be 100, maybe 101 in Ontario over the weekend. Still 96 Sunday, but then look at this, cooling down to 89 by next Tuesday. Again, we may not get a 100 degree day out of this, and so this may not be an excessively hot summer. Certainly July is not starting out that way. I'll have another update to a forecast for the valley and for the mountains coming up right here later this evening.